Hello everyone, this is Sheila Ratna Bansode. Today we'll have a quick review on introduction to the refrigeration systems along with selection of refrigerant and the most popularly used refrigeration cycle, that is vapor compression refrigeration cycle. Learning outcome: the students will be able to define the refrigeration process. Students will be able to identify the components of the vapor compression refrigeration system. What is refrigeration? Refrigeration can be defined as the process of removing heat from a body or enclosed space so that its temperature is first lowered and then maintained at a level below the temperature of surrounding. In such a case, the body or enclosed space is said to be refrigerated system. The equipment used to maintain the required temperature is called refrigerating equipment. The working substance used to produce refrigeration is called the refrigerant. The heat withdrawn from the refrigerated space is finally rejected to atmosphere, which acts as a natural receiver of heat. It should be noted that heat commences to flow into refrigerated body from surroundings as soon as the temperature of the body falls below that of the atmosphere. It constitutes an undesirable heat gain by the refrigerated body, and it is reduced considerably by protecting the refrigerated space by insulating materials. Examples are refrigerators and air conditioners, which follows the refrigeration process. The working substance that is used to carry out the refrigeration process is called as refrigerant. Refrigerant can be classified into two types: the primary refrigerants and the secondary refrigerants. The primary refrigerants are the fluids which are directly used as working fluids, whereas secondary refrigerants are liquids used for transporting thermal energy from one location to another. Fluids suitable for refrigeration purpose are nothing but refrigerants. However, important practical issues such as the system design, size, initial and operating costs, safety, reliability, and serviceability, etc., depend very much on the type of refrigerant selected for a given application. Selection criteria of refrigerant. Selection is based on the following points. First, the thermodynamic properties. The thermodynamic properties such as the suction pressure, the discharge pressure, the pressure ratio, latent heat of vaporization, isentropic index of compression, liquid specific heat, vapor specific heat, thermal conductivity, viscosity. The thermodynamic properties are interrelated and mainly depend on normal boiling point, critical temperature, molecular weight, and structure. Second, the environmental properties. At present, the environment friendliness of the refrigerant is a major factor in deciding the usefulness of a particular refrigerant. The important environmental and safety properties are ozone depletion potential, global warming, refrigerants directly contributing to global warming when released to atmosphere. Indirect contribution based on energy consumption of, among others, the compressors. Next, the global warming potential. Next, total equivalent warming index. The factor total equivalent warming index considers both direct and indirect contributions of refrigerants to global warming. Flammability. The refrigerant should preferably non-flammable and non-explosive. Chemical stability. The refrigerant should be chemically stable as long as they are inside the refrigeration system. Compatibility with common materials of construction. Ease of leak detection. In the event of leakage of refrigerant from the system, it should be easy to detect the leaks. And last, the economic properties. The refrigerant used should preferably be inexpensive and easily available. Now let's have the most commonly used vapor refrigeration system, called as vapor refrigeration, vapor compression refrigeration system. The vapor compression refrigeration system is by far the most popular and widely used system in refrigeration and air conditioning, both for industrial and domestic applications. In this system, the working substance is a refrigerant like NH3, R11, R12, R22. A refrigerant readily evaporates and condenses depending upon the pressure and temperature during the cycle. Therefore, refrigerant undergoes a change of phase alternatively between liquid and vapor phases without leaving the system. During evaporation, it absorbs latent heat from the brine or cold chamber, and during the process, liquid changes into vapor, hence creates cooling effect in the cold chamber. During concentration, refrigerant rejects heat to external system like cooling water or to the atmosphere, and the refrigerant converts from vapor to liquid. As you can see, the schematic diagram of a vapor compression refrigeration system. The system mainly consists of a refrigerant compressor, a condenser, a refrigerant control valve called as expansion valve, and an evaporator. Let's have a look on how the vapor compression refrigeration system works. When the compressor is started, it draws the low pressure vapor from the evaporator. It may be wet vapor or dry saturated refrigerant or superheated vapor, and compresses it isentropically to a sufficiently high pressure. Since the compression work is done on the vapor, its temperature also increases. Hot vapor from compressor under pressure is discharged into the condenser, where it is cooled at constant pressure by rejecting heat to condenser, cooling medium usually water or surrounding air. This converts the hot vapor into saturated liquid. This liquid at high pressure is then piped to a refrigerant control valve or expansion valve, which regulates the flow of liquid into the evaporator. This control valve, while restricting the flow, also reduces the pressure of the liquid, with the result the liquid change into vapor of low dryness fraction. During this process, the temperature of the refrigerant reduces corresponding to its temperature. Finally, the low pressure, low temperature refrigerant passes through the evaporator coil where it absorbs its latent heat from the cold chamber at constant pressure and converts into vapor. It is again supplied to the compressor, thus the cycle is completed. Thank you.